Good morning, children. Children, I welcome you all to today's session of maths. Maths first, rather, and we will be today also solving the concept sheets. And today, perhaps one of the most beautiful, you can call one of the most good-looking branches of mathematics is what we will be handling, and that is geometry. Right? Today we will be handling the chapter geometry. The questions related to it. Now, geometry word can be divided into two parts. The first being G-E-O, geo. And then the second part is metry, M-E-T-R-Y. Geo means geographical figures, geographical structures, and metry is measurement. So, the measurement of geographical structures which are there around us, right, whatever is there, is what we are going to study in geometry. Now, in geometry, basically, this measurement is of two types. First, in terms of length, breadth, right, in centimeter, and the second is in angles. In angles. Now, from these two, lots of things are derived. Right, lots of things are derived from this. Basically, geometry, you can call the figures in geometry which are formed are due to playing with points. You know, we play with points to form different figure. We join the points, we add a point, we subtract one point to change the figures. So let us move on to this very interesting concept sheet here. See, now the first question, a line has dash end point. Right, a line has dash end point. Now line is finite, means it is fixed, so it will have fixed end points which will be 2 in number, so you can call it 2. A ray is not fixed, right? A ray of light coming from sun is not fixed, so it has infinite number of points, end points, which are, so here the answer will be infinite. The line dash can be measured. Which part of line can be measured? It is called line segment. We can measure it. A line segment has how many end points? A line segment again has 2 end points, right? A line segment has 2 end points. So a dash can be extended on both sides. So there are 3 things here: line, ray, line segment. What we can extend? We can extend the ray because it is infinite on both sides, right? So this is how you need to do this. Name the ray segments or lines in the following. Now see, children, if the dot are at the end, then it is a line, right? Now, if there are arrows but the dot is in between, right, so that will be ray. And in between the two, the just as seen the first diagram, it's of a ray. And in between there are 2 points P and Q, so these will be segments. Okay. For further clarifications, please refer to your book. Okay, now let us come. Mark pairs of point and draw ray AB. You have to draw here just the YC verse of question number 2. Then fourth, does a cuboid have any curved face? Cuboid is basically like a box, match box. It does not have any curves in it. It has only straight lines. So no. How many plane faces does a cylinder have? Now we have seen a cylindrical C or pencil, when it is not sharpened, when you purchase it new, it's a little bit cylindrical in shape. So the side surfaces are curved and the top and bottom surface are flat or plane, right? So this is how you need to do this, right? So I stop here. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did in making it. And until we meet again, it's a goodbye.